The Genetics and Genealogy Project is an effort to make science relevant and engaging to today's students. Students often find science to be dull and kind of remote, removed from their everyday life. So by asking them to think about science in the context of their own genetics and their own ancestry, we're making it exciting. They're asked to look at their skin pigmentation genes and explore whether the skin pigmentation genes they have can basically explain the skin tone that they have.
We were able to match our skin color to a skin color pamphlet that told us about the amount of vitamin D and folate that our ancestors had in their skin. So I thought that that was particularly interesting to learn about, and that's just something that was so special about this course, is that I was learning more things about me while I was learning science.
So they measure their phenotype, which is what it looks like, and then they measure their genotype, which is what they get from the company. And then they try to figure out, how is it that we see so much variation in the skin pigmentation in humans?
It was also very personal to be able to do it with your own DNA, and it helped me, it made me a lot more excited about the project.
Isn't there something happening on Saturday?
There probably is. The Genealogy Project, we're looking more at ourselves and how it applies to different places around us and how everything relates together. So that's what I like getting out of the class, that's what I'm getting out of the class, how it more applies to us in the world as opposed to just facts and textbook.
A lot of variation disappears from the population. So it's interesting that in your example, although I killed off everyone except 7 people in the front, you still had pretty much the exact kind of variation at the end.
She didn't really get up to the board and lecture. She would pull up a case study, we would talk about it, and through that we would learn the material that we were supposed to read in the book the weekend before, the night before, whatever. And so it was different, but it was extremely helpful, and I didn't have a class like that in high school.
Students were asked about their level of engagement in the course, how much effort they were willing to put into studying for the course, and how excited they were about the course in general. And it's very exciting to see that they report very high levels of engagement with all aspects of the course because of the personalized approach.
All populations, you would see a reduction in variation, but you don't see it just by chance in our populations. I'm sad.
She's always asking us questions so that we stay engaged and so that we're learning. So she'll say, well, why does this happen? Why do you think this happens because of this? So that really keeps us engaged, and it's a better learning process altogether, especially because it's such a big class.
We also learned different things about us in our labs, so it was a further extension of that information, applying that information to real world science. And I really think that our class really enjoyed that because that was something that we had never done before.
I think this is a very rich, rich curriculum. It can be explored using lenses from different disciplines and for different purposes. And I'm hoping to take it to that level in the coming years.